Agency fans, and welcome back to Munich, Germany. We are here at the very end of day two of Salonis' Cellosphere. My name is Savannah Peterson. As you can imagine, I'm sitting here with Rob Stressage, just like I have been for the last few days. Final segment with the guests.
I'm excited. I think that, you know, I could go all night long because these guests have been awesome. Talking about their stories and where they really, how they got into this is been very fascinating and very wide-ranging.
Absolutely. And it really makes the platform and the solution feel very real.
Yes.
Avi, thank you so much for bringing your wonderful customer story here today. How you doing?
There you go. Thank you for having me here.
You still got a big smile on your face and a lot of energy. How have the past few days been?
Fantastic. I'm so pumped up. You have no idea.
We love to hear that. It's a lot of stuff to hear that. And, tell us a little bit about your role in Vinmar. Big company. Been around for a while. Give us an overview.
Sure. My name is Avi Banerjee, and I'm the Director of Digital Transformation at Vinmar. Vinmar is a distribution company, and it's a $5 billion revenue, and we distribute mostly chemicals and plastics around the world. So every refinery is a potential supplier for us, and every customer which uses plastic molding is a potential customer for us. So, yeah, it's a very heavy logistics company.
I was going to say, yeah, so supply chain and logistics seems like there's a theme of that here, funny enough, and process intelligence really seems to factor into helping people optimize that. But where did you guys get started with Salonis, and when was that?
Absolutely. Actually, my boss, the CEO of the company, who's a very visionary person, young, dynamic, he fell in love with Salonis, and he hired me to install Salonis in Vinmar. So when I started the journey with Salonis 3 years ago, I didn't know anything about Salonis. But the journey has been very fruitful, both for Vinmar and me personally. And I'm so excited to be here with you guys.
So what was the first use case that you figured out to go after?
Absolutely. So like every other customer, we started looking at process mining to find inefficiencies in process. But very early on, I was fortunate enough to see an application called Execution App, the Sales Order Execution App. So I don't know if I go into a little bit more details. Process mining, what it does is it looks at the past and tells you how you can improve for the future. While the Execution App actually looks at future and prevents you from making mistakes now, looking at the implications of that in the future. So that is such a powerful tool for us. So what we did is we quickly changed direction and started implementing what we call a Sales Order Execution App, which is nothing but a glorified risk management. Risk that will prevent us to ship on time. So the more we mitigate the risk up front, the more we are able to ship on time and more happy customers. That's the journey with Salonis, with Vinmar.
You're absolutely trying to future-proof yourself there.
Exactly right.
There's no landmines lurking out there. In my notes here, I see you've got 50 offices in 35 countries and sales in 110 countries. That is massive reach.
It is massive. At any given time, we have thousands of sales orders open in our system, and we have a large number of our workforce just dedicated to make sure that our customers receive the order on time. So that heavy lift was a perfect use case for Salonis, because Salonis process mining engine can be fine-tuned to make sure that we identify the risk well in advance, so we mitigate the known causes, because there are certain situations that are beyond our control. But the ones that are in our control definitely can be mitigated with the help of Salonis.
And you said your CEO was very visionary in bringing you in to really go down this path.
Exactly.
Where do you see this expanding within your company?
So I report to my boss. His name is Sergeant Zanuka. And his vision and my marching order is to make logistics touchless. Let me expand on that a little bit.
Yeah.
Because
yeah,
that's really visionary. That's where the world is moving towards. There is no reason why a sales order can move through the sequence of events all the way from logistics, that is fulfillment, to invoice by still known as automation. Now, granted, there is a subset of sales order that will need some human intervention because things have not gone according to plan. But the vast majority of them surely can be automated. So that's the vision that I have marching order to fulfill. And that's the reason why I was so focused in the concept of orchestration engine. Orchestration engine, and this, by the way, when I started work implementing SAP, Celonis, SAP and Celonis synonymous for me. It's the same
thing.
It's exactly right. Around a year and a half ago, I came across this concept of orchestration engine. And at that time, it was not very well known across all the Celonis customers. Very few of us actually knew about it. And I was one of the first off the bat to actually try. And we have been successfully implemented it for one of our business units. This is a fairly large business unit, more than $700 million, which automatically, without human intervention, is able to take an order for shipment all the way to actual fulfillment. And it's managed by Celonis Orchestration Engine. So very excited.
And so that process is completely automated now.
Correct. As far as things don't go outside the plan deviation. So if we may have a catastrophic incident where a human intervention is required. If not, then yes, automatically we push it through the system.
So what sorts of benefits do you receive from that? I can imagine you're saving money, you're saving time, your customers are getting more value from the transaction because it's getting there quicker and more efficiently.
So one of the biggest KPIs that I personally focus is shipment on time. Any automation that we do allows us to get closer to the perfection. This perfection is 10 out of 10. But let's assume that we come close to it, we reach 95% threshold, then it's a huge win for us. Automation gets us there, and most importantly, it improves the work-life balance of our employees because employees don't have to do the mundane, repetitive task. A human is best used when they solve problems, and that's what we are doing. We are making sure that our workforce is focused on solving problems, while Celonis is focused on moving the needle all the way to invoice, and that's how we divide the work.
I think that's so critical, and nobody, you know, people talk about automation or AI as taking jobs. It's not.
It's not.
Taking the boring out of our jobs.
It's
taking the repetitive out of our jobs and letting us do purpose-driven, really valuable work. What sort of creative solutions do you think you'll be able to create with the time now that your team has to do more impactful things?
Customer satisfaction. In our line of business as a distribution company, mostly distribution, we do have a little bit of manufacturing in under Winmar International, but we are 90% plus distribution. Customer satisfaction rates number one, and that can be done if we dedicate our workforce to make sure the customer has a clear understanding where they are in terms of receiving the shipment. And that can be done if I can take out some of the work that they do to make sure the shipment is reaching on time, rather than focusing on the mundane activity, they can be focused on customer to make sure they know exactly where it is. And technology has gone a long way to do that for us.
So I just was talking to the guys that won the Game Changer Award around network and things like that. What things are you looking at? Because it would seem that you're in distribution, it would seem like something like network is something that you could foresee potentially helping your help from a supply chain perspective, especially on the distribution side.
Absolutely. So this ecosystem, let me tell you this, next 5 to 6 years, the primary focus of major software and major distribution and major 3PL system is connectivity. We need to connect right from our supplier to the distributor to the customer seamlessly. This is where the focus is going to be. And I think Celonis Orchestration Engine will play a central role in many companies because it is fairly significantly easy to turn it on once you get the database for that. and normalize it.
That's a pretty magical thing to be able to say. When we think about business-wide software and platform solutions, we don't always get the term easy.
That's exactly right. So let me explain that at a very high level.
Yeah, please.
Let's take an example for the risk assessment of Celonis, because first and foremost, you cannot automate a process that is not optimized or that is going to hurt us. So you only start the automation journey or you start the automation process once you're 100% sure that that order that you're automating is a good order.
Right.
Right? You're not hurting anybody by doing that. Celonis Execution App has a very easy to configure risk assessment, and these risks pop up near real time. If you go over that and if you look at the orchestration engine itself, mm-hmm.